Morning, everyone. This is Peter Yosef, analyst at Iron Facts, bringing you the morning comment for the 1st of February. Inflation rising this year according to the Fed. No change was made in the policy rate in the 31st of January FOMC meeting, and the interest rate remained at 1.25% to 1.5%. The US dollar did not substantially strengthen as the decision was widely expected by the market. The accompanying statement was slightly hawkish, and its tone could accommodate 4 hikes in 2018, as the use of the phrase "further gradual adjustments" in the accompanying statement could open the door to that scenario. Overall, it had an upbeat assessment of the US economy, citing solid gains in employment, household spending and investment. The main issue addressed, however, was inflation, which the Fed ceased to rise and stabilized in 2018 around Fed's target of 2%. It could be the case that inflation may begin to rise from early this spring. We see the accompanying statement supporting the US dollar somewhat, however, on the long run and ahead of the March meeting. The US dollar moved in a sideways manner yesterday, staying well within the range set by the 1.2355 support line and the 1.2495 resistance line. The pair could continue to trade in a sideways manner over the short term, however, there could be some selling pressures, as the US dollar may be expected to strengthen ahead of non-farm payroll Friday. Should the pair come under selling interest, we could see it breaking the 1.2355 support level and aim for the 1.2230 support barrier. Should it come under buying interest, we could see it breaking the 1.2495 resistance level and aim for the 1.26 resistance hurdle. On other news headlines, there seems to be no clear UK heading for Brexit. Media reports suggest that the UK government has no clear plan as to what kind of post-Brexit relationship it wants with the EU. Evident of that would be Theresa May's latest statement, where she stated that there should be different rights for EU nationals who arrive in the UK. The statement practically reopens the issue of EU nationals' rights in the UK, increasing uncertainty. According to various analysts, the ideal relationship would be a bespoke relationship modeled after the Canada model, with a twist that would enable UK financial services to be included in the European Common Economic Area. However, such a scenario was missing from yesterday's leaked report, raising various eyebrows on whether the UK government sees the case as feasible. The EU side seems to be slowly toughening up its position, as EU leaders may start focusing on internal issues such as more federalization of the Eurozone and the upcoming Italian elections. We see the case for the headlines to weaken the GBP as Brexit issues mount for the UK government. In contrast to yesterday's forecast for the possibility of a slightly bearish market, Cable again posted some gains, breaking the 1.4175 resistance line, now turned to support. We see the case for Cable to trade in sideways manner in the short term. However, we would like to point out that Cable could experience some selling pressures as the market may start positioning itself ahead of the non-farm payrolls Friday. Should the bulls take the reins of the pair's direction, we could see the pair aiming for the 1.4325 resistance level, and should that be breached, hover slightly above it. Should the bears have the upper hand, we could see the pair breaking the 1.4175 support line and aim for the 1.4040 support level. As for today's other economic highlights, during the European morning we get UK's nationwide housing price index for January. Also, France's, Germany's and Eurozone's manufacturing PMI are to be released for January. All could influence the euro. The UK side, we get the manufacturing PMI also for January. Last but not least, the US ISM manufacturing PMI is to be released for January and could have an impact on the US dollar. For more information, please read the full comment on ironfx.com or download our app and get all the information you need to trade. Also, you can follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, subscribe to our YouTube channel, or circle us on Google+ to get more trading ideas. This is Peter Yosef, analyst at IronFX, wishing you solid trading.